Since our last video on the mini golf game, I've been able to get it to a working prototype that has a completed replay loop. I wanted to share some of the tricks and techniques I've used so far in the game to get it to this point. Before you go, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the thumbs up icon. Both take a few seconds, are absolutely free, and help out the channel a ton. Aside from the function of the ball, which we covered in the last video, the hole is the most important thing in a mini golf game. So I did spend a little bit of time on it, and let me tell you, it's mostly, if not entirely, smoke and mirrors, and I think it's wonderful. I wanted to be able to really quickly create courses and not have to model a new mesh with a hole in it for every course. I also know from using Unity in the past that edges tend to be problem areas within Unity's physics system. So that's kind of what necessitated the way this was done. If I zoom in on the hole, you can see that it looks great, and I can even see the bottom of it from above. I know that that might seem pretty trivial, but what if I told you that that's not actually what's happening? Yeah, there's not actually a hole here, at least not in the way that you'd think. If I go into the hole game object, there's this cutout mesh that uses a mask which hides the ground to reveal a cylinder below. The cylinder is straight out of Unity. It has a top, but you can't see it because I've set the material render face to back, so you can only see the inside of a cylinder from this view. I'd love to be able to take credit for coming up with this whole mask and hidden object technique, but I followed a tutorial on the slidefactory.com, which I'll link in the description. With this method, I can move the hole anywhere I want and it looks great. I will say it's kind of finicky to set up because there's lots of little details and I don't think I could do it again without going through the tutorial, so just be forewarned. It's currently working in Unity version 2020.3.9F1, but I upgraded to the alpha version of Unity and it broke and I had no idea how to fix it, so good luck. Aside from that, the issue with this setup is that it's not actually a real hole, it's purely visual, so the ball won't fall into it. So instead, I use a trigger on the hole that tracks how long the ball has been in contact with it. If the ball meets or exceeds that time threshold, the ball is teleported to the top center of the hole and disabled. Simultaneously, a new ball with a different collision matrix is enabled, and that dummy ball drops into the hole. To add back in a bit of realism, I created a Vortex script that uses a capsule collider trigger. This script will pull the ball towards the hole when it's close. It gives the kind of feeling that the ball is skirting over the edge of the hole and being redirected by it. I think it's pretty convincing, but I'd love to know what you think in the comments. I also created it in a pretty generic way so that I can use it in other things in the future. I added an out-of-bounds script that uses a single trigger that represents the playable area per level and tracks any physics on exit events. If the ball exits this area, it gets reset to its last location before the shot. The last location gets saved within the shoot method before everything else happens, so it's literally the last position saved. I also added in a main menu that shows each level and keeps track of your personal bests and how you did on your last play of that level. I also locked each level until you've beaten the previous one. I'm currently not too happy with this main menu and think that it could be way better, but I've been having trouble coming up with any other ideas. Maybe I could show par and your personal best for the hole. Maybe showing a series best at the end would be cool too. To go along with that, I also made a level spawner. That way my levels can spawn into the same scene and I don't have to worry about managing tons of individual scenes. There's also a jump ability if you click on the ball while it's moving. It's basically a skill mechanic at this point, since you need to be able to shoot the ball and then also have CSGO Grand Champion aim to be able to click on the ball while it's moving. I'm not sure if I'll keep it or not, but it currently doesn't have much use in the levels that I've built. And I think that's pretty much it so far. So if you want to learn more, check out the video on the screen and let me know what you thought in the comments down below.